Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we are exploring Obduction. We're here on Kaptar, which I now know the name of because the save file for the game, when I loaded it in, says that we're on Kaptar. So that's cool. Since this is Kaptar, I'm gonna say it's safe to assume. Probably, maybe. Or I could be wrong, I don't know. It might be safe to assume that, the jungle area is Marae, like they talked about before. So, who knows? We'll see. This thing... what is this? What? Oh, we can't pick it back up. At least not from here. Maybe, okay, yeah, from here we can pick it back up by the looks of it. Oh, no, we can't. Oops. What does that do? Oh! Okay, so this bar was up and blocking the bridge from going this way over here. But now that it's over here, not only can we access it from this side, but we can also go over here. And let me guess, this isn't... yep. Not working yet, but at some point we're gonna probably deactivate that red laser up there, just like we did in Hunrath. And that'll let us go into the wall. Sweet! Okay. Alright. Well, now that we've got that all figured out, completely on accident, let's continue along the cliff edge here. Hello, Mr. Glowbug. What's up? There's a whole ton of you around here, ain't there? I wonder if this is the planet those things originally come from. That could be the case. That'd be pretty damn cool. Honestly, this is pretty damn cool regardless. I've already pointed out how much this area reminds me of Riven. Sorry, I have to fix my headphones there. They were at a weird angle. Yeah, I love the, I don't even know how to describe it, honestly. Like, with all the rocks and everything around, and the sort of, these sculptures that look sort of like, you know, island statue type things, and that combined with all the old, over-engineered machinery, it's just, oh, it's awesome. It's awesome. It's such a uniquely Cyan way of doing things. These caves are pretty damn cool, too. That's got to be important. Jot that down while you all listen to the music. So that's a lizard-looking thing. Gone and sketched it down real quick. And, oh shit, there's a whole bunch of them all over. Oh, okay, never mind. I just completely wasted my time. Oh, there's a whole bunch of these things. Okay, never mind. I guess those aren't exactly important at the moment. Though they might become important later. Because there are different... They all seem to clearly be the same animal, some type of... Actually, they look more like fish now. This one with the tail curved around made it look sort of like a lizard. But looking at them at all the different angles, they seem to be fish, actually. And there's also the wavy lines, which I guess is supposed to be water. So who knows, this might become important later. Maybe we have to notice some pattern in the, like, the way their tails are swinging or something. Who knows? Who knows? I don't. Oh well. At least now I have a cute picture of a fish in my notebook. Oh, that looks awesome! Yo. Okay. Stop standing still with your mouth agape. Try to focus. Do the puzzles, Brody. Yeesh. Is that the first time I've ever said my real name in a video? I didn't even realize. Echo. Just call me Echo. Jeez, oh, yeesh. Nobody call me by my real name. That's weird. Oh. Okay, so yeah, the red light's coming over there. Probably should head towards the red light. I'm betting. But there's so much around here to look at. And it really is awesome. There's a crane up there. Oh, there's whole kinds of machinery over here. Little glow bugmen. They're all leading me towards the red light, it looks like. Okay, what the hell is this thing? This is huge. Oh boy. Anything we can do here? Nope, doesn't look like it. Okay. Yeah, so these are some really heavy-duty chains connecting these two places. Is this going to be like a platform that moves across? I get the feeling, but... No. No, actually, this seems to be connected to the stairs and everything else, so... I don't think it could move across. Huh. Amazing view, though. Alright. Back down the stairs. Let's go. Let's see, can we move over here? Yes, we can. Okay, that looks like it'll take us to the laser. And what's over here on this side? Oh, okay. We can still get to the laser over here. Oh, and all sorts of those... I saw one over there. Oh, and they're all on the stairs, too. I didn't notice those. What's with those shells? They look like seashells. Huh. Okay. Oh, maybe this thing gets pulled across. Alright. Alright, we'll keep that in mind. There's stairs on the other side, but they're blocked off at the moment because the thing is in the middle. But even if the thing was moved, those stairs there don't go down all the way. So how would we get across? Oh, these tapestries seem to be made of the shells, but not quite, maybe? Hmm. Yeah, no, I think they are. Obviously, they kept the tapestries as just a flat thing because that's easier to model it, I guess. But the shells do look like actual 3D objects, but I'm pretty sure they're supposed to be the same. Okay, anyway. Let's move over here. Oh. Oh. This looks like a... Okay, well, there's a map. Okay, cool. But this looks like a building out of Hunrath. It's got the same red rocks. Oh. And it's got a little teleportation thing. Oh, this is crazy. But I don't want to leave here. I just got here. We can't even access the red thing. Hmm. Okay, but hold on. Oh, boy. Okay, this is cool. So here's what I'm thinking has happened. We transported two here from Hunrath. And, all of these teleportation things take a perfect sphere with them. So this section of wherever this comes from is from a place on Hunrath. So if we take this back to Hunrath and then walk back to the other teleportation thing and come back here, then this whole sphere should be gone and replaced with whatever was originally in this spot on Kaptar. Okay, so we're gonna do that, but I'm also going to, oh, this map doesn't even show us the locations of all the different teleportations. Hmm. Well, obviously, some of these paths, like this path, or that path, or that path, those lead right into the wall, so those will be teleportation sections, of course. But anyway, I'm gonna jot this down real quick, so I'll cut it here. Okay, so after jotting down the whole map and taking a pretty good look at it, seems actually pretty simple, like there's a pretty simple layout. Down here, this orange spot seems to be a marker for the teleportation device that we took from Hunrath to get here. And then from there we came down here, and this is the bridge that we were on, the rotating bridge. And obviously we rotated it to get access to over here. We took this path up. And then this big area right here seems to be this whole round courtyard out here that we came into when we looked up in that big machine. And that, those chains seem to be the dulled outline right there. So the big machine would be right here. The dulled outline going across the big gap, obviously, showing that it leads across the big gap to the other land mass over there. There's obviously another section over here that's big and open with some paths leading off. And there's a path on the other land mass and all sorts of paths over here. There's some more markers, presumably for other teleportation devices that lead to a different planet, I guess. And then another one right here, this is where we currently are. This orange marker, same shade of orange as the one down there, showing that this leads to Hunrath, and again, evidenced by the fact that there's the red rocks all around, so yes, this leads to Hunrath. The red dot would seem to be a marker for the device that's shooting out the red laser. That looks like a tree, so right over in that direction, on the other side of that wall, should be the tree for this planet that we want to get connected, like CW told us. And then over here, there's a big gap of nothing, so I presume this path leads to a dead end, and then this the path leads over here to another marker, possibly. These dulled out markers, these ones here, could be buildings. But the fact that they're perfect circles makes me think they're more teleportation devices. Or maybe it's just simply sections of the world that are not Kaptar. That could be another thing. Instead of... Maybe they're not all necessarily teleportation devices like these two are. Maybe they just happen to be spheres from other worlds that were put there. Over here is another big landmass of nothing, but with a building of some kind suspended over it. And presumably these two are pathways leading up to the building. So, yeah. All pretty straightforward by the looks of it. And now that we've done all this, let's teleport away back to Hunrath. And this will take us to a completely new area. And by the look of the little section of building that we're in, I'm guessing this will probably lead us behind that locked door that was on the other side of the river in Hunrath. Either that, or maybe it'll lead us into the cave where the minecart was able to lead? I'm not sure. We'll see. Well, let's just not move the mouse around. It makes the frame rate go to shit. Jeez. Unfortunately. Very unfortunately. Oh well, by the way, this is actually cool though. Now that, this is sort of like a... This sort of reminds me of like... how time travel is used in a lot of games, like with Ocarina of Time, or like the Dark World in Twilight Princess. I think Ghost Trick also has some elements of this, where you have to like sort of travel into the past in order to do something to affect, you know, the future and unlock new areas. A lot of video games that incorporate that way, where you have to go into the past and do something so that an object is no longer in the way, so when you go back to the future, you can access a new area. And this obviously isn't time travel that we're doing here, but it seems to be... Oh, yep, okay, so we're in the back room of that house that leads to the, like, mining area that was back here. Okay. Cool. Either way, it's out of the way, so that now Kaptar should be all clear for us to get the thing over there. Get to the red laser. But now that this is here, let me walk over here and see if there's anything new to it. Oh, okay. Oh. Interesting. There's a button on the back of this. Okay, first off, let me see. Would there be any advantage to bringing the cart through here? Maybe. Maybe we're supposed to bring the cart over here for some reason. Somehow hook it up to the water vein? Kind of doubt that, but because where is the cart now? I forgot where I put it. Should I check these rocks? These aren't more holograms, are they? No. They don't seem to be. Okay. Hmm. I'm suspicious, though. To be honest, I wasn't a fan of driving the cart around, so I don't want to drive it all over the place just to test it, but we might have to. I'm not sure. Where'd I put the damn thing? I guess it's just somewhere over on this side of the place. But, there it is, okay. So, if we were to back it up here... Pull it out that way. And then it'd be going backwards... This way, we take it through here. It goes over here. Then it would go over here. Then it would go over here. And it would go through here. Again, backwards. Oh, and it would be standing... It would be standing within the sphere. So we can teleport it to Kaptar and destroy the red device. Oh, that's so fucking cool. Okay. Yeah, because I was wondering how we were actually going to destroy the vice, because we would need the blue laser to destroy the red device. But we can't do that if there isn't a blue laser in the other world. So yeah, let's go bring this bad boy over. Hello again, cart. Your skills are required. Alright, how do I... No, no, not space! Please stop. I forgot how to... See. There you go. See. Jeez. Alright. Turn on. Oh wait, no, not that. Move forward. There you go. Alright. Let's back you up. All the way. I'm really glad that I have a picture of the inside of the cart now. Wouldn't want to forget what it looks like. Forgot what the button was for switching the cursor type. Oh well. I recently played through Myst 3 Exile. And it has the exact same kind of, view thingy, whatever you want to call it, in that you, normally, you look around with the cursor always in the middle, and the view follows your cursor, but then you press a button, and then it switches to free, but in that game, it's, right click to switch between cursor modes, and I actually think that's a little more intuitive. Ironically, considering everything else about Myst 3 was not that great. Oh well. Alright. Let's head on through. Oh, this is such a cool thing. Such a cool way of designing the puzzle. Though honestly, I do want to still go back and take the other teleportation thing back over. Though I'll need to move the bridge again, or I won't be able to. I should go do that. I should put the bridge back in the spot it originally was. Oh wait, I can't. That's right. Damn it. Alright, well, move back. And then switch that. Oh wait, actually, yeah, WASD can be used for it. Switch that off, pull it back a bit more. Oh no, not too much. Right there? Nope. Okay. Back a bit more. Actually, wait a minute. How far back can I go? Okay, yeah, that would definitely be too far. How about right here? Nope. Okay. There you go. Awesome. Yep. So that's all disappearing. Unfortunately, we can't see it from in here. Oh well. But yeah, so if I... Oh, jeez. Move forward a bit more. Back and teleport back to Unwrath. So yeah, I'm thinking about it. If I go and I move the bridge back into position so that from the first teleporter that I can get on the bridge, then I can't go to the other side to get to this second teleporter that we're using right now. And if I use this teleporter to go back, and then go through Hunrath and use the first teleporter to go back to Kaptar, well then the bridge has been moved, so I won't be able to get across the gap. So, oops. I wanted to, try and, I mean, obviously the goal of the game, I know now, though I did theorize this at the beginning, the goal of the game is not to repair the planets and put all the spheres back to where they belong. It's still, I think it would still be nice to put them back where they belong, because it makes moving through the areas a lot easier, you know? Having the, the cart be able to move along the track, and having the back of that building corrected, and then whatever the, section of Kaptar look like would allow us to walk over towards the red beam. You know, it'd be nice to be able to actually walk through that area as it was intended. Oh well. And while we're here, I'm actually gonna back up. Just because from this angle, I wonder if there's anything we can see that the that maybe we couldn't get to before. Maybe a bit further. No, I doubt it. But still, going all the way back here, I can't help wondering if we're supposed to bring this back here. I mean, the water line thing there is obviously broken off, and there's nothing in this machine, this rail car thing, that makes it look like it needs water or anything anyways, so I don't know. But for some reason I feel like it's supposed to be back here. We couldn't access this this area before with the cart, so, you know, make me wonder. For now, let's go put it back, though. I guess I can always sit through those incredibly long loading times to fix it again if it turns out I do want this to go back over there. And you know what? Let's get out. Well, we have to get out regardless. But let's turn this way. Keep this going that way. And this going that way. That'll take us right towards those rocks. Let me see. I know they don't have the red shimmer effect on them, so they shouldn't be destructible, but it's too suspicious that they're there. It honestly is. And like every other spot we've seen that has those rocks all piled up was a section that turned out to be a hologram that we had to destroy in order to access an area. And we haven't accessed every area in Hunrath, so, you know, making me wonder. Very suspicious. I'm gonna do it just in case. Just in case, I don't know, maybe I'm blind. Maybe the game glitched out. Fine. Whoops, 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 whoa. God. Fucking thing. Alright, hold up. Let me get out real quick. Did this have anything important to say? Waterfall.
Part of our ecosystem here is our supply of water. It is supplied as a natural process of the system itself, but we don't really understand how.
Okay. Cool. Good on you for not understanding how it works. You have proven to be a brilliant scientist. Now let me destroy this. Nope. Okay. Alright. I stand corrected. Let me just move this back. I'm nervous about getting stuck in that stupid telephone pole thing. So yeah, I knew with the other, what are they fucking called? The illusion hologram thingies. We actually had to destroy one of these type of devices to get the projection to stop. So I thought maybe if they were tricky and they decided to use this one to do both, like, you know, the thing. Why does it keep putting the character shadow on, goddammit? I keep turning that setting off. Ugh. Anyway, it keeps, you know, if they were tricky and they decided to have this be the explanation for the waterfall, but it was also simultaneously creating the illusion for the rocks, that's what I thought that maybe it was doing. So, okay, but nope, we are all out of time for this episode, and we gotta go head back to Kaptar. And, yeah, so we'll do that in the next episode. Hope you all have enjoyed this, and I will see you all later. Buh-bye.